Welcome to Book Time with Ryan. I'm Ryan, and today I'll be talking about drowning. And we should all have a healthy fear of drowning. This is by TJ Newman. It's her second book, and it is Drowning, the Rescue of Flight 1421. What a cool cover. And even cool, maybe not even cooler than, but also cool, look at the end papers. Ooh, that is a little chilling. I got this book as soon as it came out. I took it with me on my trip to London. Check out my trip to London in my London vlog. And I flew there, obviously, because it's not 1830. And I can sure as hell assure you that I am not going to read a book about a plane underwater when I'm flying over water. Or probably flying over land. So I didn't read this while I was in London. But I did read it pretty quickly. I think it took me 2 days, and I loved it. I did a video maybe a year or two ago about my top 10 books for, I think, 2021. And TJ Newman's first book, Falling, was on that list. It was in the top, I think, top three. So I knew that I liked the way TJ Newman writes, and I was excited for this book. And for good reason. It was great. I guess before I start, it's an interesting time to read this. Not only because I was recently on a plane flying over water, but there was also recently a kind of a tourist submarine that I guess sank, lost contact, that was looking at the Titanic wreck. And I had a different thumbnail planned out. I actually did the thumbnail as soon as I started the book because I just knew what I wanted it to look like. But I showed it to my dad, and after kind of talking to him, it seemed like it probably was insensitive to use as my thumbnail considering what's going on, and that they haven't found, at least last I saw, they had not found or contacted the submersible. So I changed it to the view of the cockpit of a Coast Guard MH-65 Dolphin helicopter, which makes appearances in this book, because I just felt like that was probably better. But I'll show you what the original thumbnail looked like. I like the way it came out, but I think just because of what's going on, it's probably more sensitive not to use that, just to not trigger anybody. Hope that they find the submersible and they find the people in the submersible alive, because it's a pretty rough situation for the loved ones that are waiting to hear something, and probably for the people that were involved. So, about this book, though. This is a book about a plane that crashes while going from Hawaii to San Francisco, California, and the process of rescuing or trying to rescue the people that are on the plane. It's an Airbus, and if any of us have really followed any ditchings in the past, especially Sully Sullenberger, you kind of know that an Airbus has systems to kind of close off everything from water. So if they ever had to ditch, it would almost not turn it into a sub, but close it all off to minimize leaking. That's what we saw when Sullenberger crashed on the Hudson. And it just kind of floated there, if you recall the rescue involved with that ditching. This ditching's further off, much deeper water, and is more violent. It's not on a river, it's on the ocean. When I read Falling had, and I think I said this in my kind of my recounting of, it's before I was doing full reviews, I think, but it starts out pretty intense, Falling. And one of the most intense beginnings I've ever read, but it was a dream or a nightmare. This starts out with a very shitty situation and gets worse and worse for everyone involved after that. And it's real. Real. It's fictional, but it's not a dream. We start the book with an explosion, and we see a plane that's out of control. that the pilots have lost control of firefighting, being able to fight the fire in the engine. They don't have a lot of the backup systems, and redundancy is kind of out the window for what's taking place on this plane. And they have to ditch in the water. Now, my dad read this before me because he was not flying over the ocean, although he has crashed in a helicopter and lived, obviously. So he had already read it, and I asked him on the phone, is there any Coast Guard in it? And he said, yeah, there is. There's like a ton of Coast Guard in this book. So I will say 5 stars for this book. 5 stars. TJ, Newman, if you ever need someone to ask questions about the Coast Guard for a book, let me know. I'm not in the Coast Guard anymore, but I was a public affairs officer for a while. And there are a couple things that I saw. The helicopter is called an HH-65. Probably about 10 or 15 years ago, they became MH-65. They were re-engined and had an extended nose. So that's one thing I saw. And then Coast Guardsman for the United States is 2 words and a proper noun. So it's Coast Guardsman. It is gender neutral. And it is one of 3 services that have proper noun names for service members. Space Force and the Marine Corps are the other 2. But other than that, we follow for most of the time. I think our main character is Will. Will is an engineer. He's separated from his wife, Chris. Chris works on underwater recovery and salvage kind of operations. And that's good for this book. And then they have a daughter, Shannon. And they had another daughter, Annie, who died before this book takes place, from a freak accident at a pool. Really sad, especially as a parent reading that, and some of the concerns that Chris and Will have for their daughter, Shannon. I think Will's probably the main character, and he is on the plane with Shannon. The captain is Kit. Kit's a woman. I think it's Kathleen, but she goes by Kit. She is the surviving captain of the plane. And then you have a mix of other people, including a guy named Andy, who I wanted to die most of the book. All the book. I wanted Andy to die from the moment that we first are introduced to him until later when things happen. But so what happens is this flight 1421 crashes, and there's a fuel leak and there's a fire. And while everyone was trying to escape the plane, it became clear that the fire, the flames outside the plane were dangerous. A lot of people died outside the plane. Some were rescued. I think we never get a total for how many were rescued and how many died. There were 99 people, including the crew, pilots. But some people, because they kind of see that this is going to ignite the fuel that's on the surface of the water with people in little life rafts that pop off the side of the plane, they stay in the plane, and then the plane starts to sink, and it comes to rest about 200 feet below the surface on this kind of little plateau, which I think was an extinct volcano, but it's teetering, and now it is up to Fitz, the District 14 commander of the Coast Guard. That's a 2-star admiral position. Rear admiral, upper half, and some Navy ships, and some Coast Guard cutters, some Coast Guard assets, and Chris to figure out how to rescue the people that are still alive in the plane. They have a bubble of air, but they're concerned about, one, some of that air leaking, two, the integrity of the fuselage and the position on the, I guess not really seabed, on that little cliff. And three, the content of the air as it becomes more and more toxic with CO2. So this is the group that's responding, and there's a major Coast Guard presence in Hawaii. And this book is the process of trying to rescue the people on board, including Chris's husband and daughter and others. There's not a whole lot of detail I can give you without kind of, I think, giving away too much. Let's just say that it's stressful. It's very stressful. Things are happening. Stuff and things happen. Sometimes things get worse. Sometimes things get better. But it's a very precarious situation they find themselves in. And a lot of things could go wrong. And I think T.J. Newman was not afraid to kill off characters. So there are characters that you'll like who will die. And there are characters who you don't like that may die too. But it's really interesting to watch some of the challenges that they run into, how they overcome those challenges, and what the approach is. And I found times where I was reading it thinking, like, why don't they just do this? And then what I was thinking comes up in the dialogue, and some characters are already thinking that too. So that was reassuring. I would definitely recommend not reading this book if you are flying on a plane over water. If you're scared of flying, don't read it while you're flying. If you are scared of sinking in the ocean in a plane, this is going to be a scary book for you. I used to be scared of flying because my dad's crash and kind of his fear rubbing off on me. And then I got comfortable understanding how many redundancies there are, how many redundant systems there are in a commercial aircraft. And then T.J. Newman comes out and crashes one where all the redundancies seem to have failed. So thanks, T.J. You probably made me scared of flying again. I am glad I didn't read this on the flight, but I'm so happy I read it. 5 stars. I think I read it in 2 days. Just a great book. T.J. Newman does it again. Apparently Falling is going to be a movie, which I'm very excited about because that was a great book. You can say with a new author, debut novel, hey, maybe this person just got lucky. But T.J. Newman has put back-to-back books on the shelves that are exciting and keep you on the edge of your seat, help you appreciate the airlines industry and the professionals that you deal with every day and kind of take for granted when you're flying. And I think you'll enjoy it. There's a lot of nail biting going on, especially at the end, and a lot of holding my breath. One of the things she does great too is that there's a countdown. You have a clock so you know how long it's been since the plane crashed. But she also kind of gives you a countdown on how much oxygen is probably left because we are kind of fighting that too. And I think the Coast Guard looks great in this too. So thanks for portraying them in a nice way and giving them an important role that's not subservient to the Navy. If you haven't read Drowning, pick it up, read it. You don't have to read Falling first, but if you haven't read Falling, I recommend reading both of them. And they're not related, except there's a plane involved. The covers are really cool for both. And just check it out. I think you'll enjoy it. I certainly did. T.J. Newman, thank you for writing another great book. I did win a T.J. Newman Falling shirt, which I had in a video. I'll try to figure out what video that was and pop up the link here. But that's it. So thanks a lot. Have a good one. I will see you later. You will come to a place where the only thing you feel are loaded.